Hello students, so in this video lecture we are continuing our timer section of third unit. In the last lecture we have already studied about the timer, that what is a timer in a 8051 microcontroller, how it is used, what are the different types of timer which are in the 8051 and all. So we'll continue that lecture and we'll revisit what we have already studied. We have studied that 8051 consists of two timers, which are namely as timer 0 and timer 1, and both are 16 bits. 16 bit means they are of 16 bit, that means they can count up to 2 to the power 16, that's it. They have two 16 bit resistors. This one and this one, both are divided into two different parts. Fine, so we can load the values into them accordingly. Fine, apart from this, both the timer uses a resistor which is known as T mode. This is a mode resistor which is used to set the mode. Fine, we have also studied the different bits in the mode resistor. The mode resistor is divided into two parts. The last four bits are for timer 0, and the upper four bits and the most significant four bits are for timer 1. Fine. Now the different bits we have also studied. The last two bits M0 and M1 are used to specify the what type of mode is used for the timer. We have four different modes depending upon the value of M0 and M1. We have also already studied this. And then the third bit is C by T, that is used for configuring our timer as a counter, or it is being used as a timer. Fine. And then the last bit, the gate. The gate bit is used to control the timer through externally through 8051. Fine. So we'll see this thing in today's lecture. Then we have done some programs to see how to control the timer using the programming. We have also seen how to generate a delay using these timers. Fine. And this is a good program which we have already done in last. This is also a good program. This one was a good program which will make you understand more about the timer. And then after this, these are some of the programs which I have given you to analyze. And after this, there was a section that how to calculate the total time delay which was generated, which to be generated by a timer. So I'm skipping this step in our syllabus. And if the students want to study, I'll share this PPT. They can study that how to calculate the what value to be given in a program for a timer. I'll skip this, and I'll also skip the related examples of this. We have already covered mode 0, mode 1, and then in today's lecture we'll cover the mode 2. Fine. So this is the mode 2. Now what does mode 2 signify? Mode 2 signify that we were using the timer resistor, which are divided into two different parts. We were using the timer resistor, for example, let us say T0. T0 was divided into two different parts, TL0 and TH0. Fine. So what we were doing in the mode 1, that we are feeding a 16 bit count to this resistor. Fine. A 16 bit count to this resistor. 16 bit count something like this, let's say FF2F. This is how much value? This is a 16 bit value. So we are feeding something like this. Fine. We are giving such value. So it starts counting after this. Fine. Till the last value, which is FFFF, is achieved. Fine. So this was in the mode 1. But what does mode 2 signify? Mode 2 shows that in the mode 2, what we will do? In the mode 2, we will feed the value. It is also known as 8 bit mode. Why? Because we will feed only to the TH0. We will feed the count, or we will give the count to the timer only to the higher 8 bits, which is TH0. I'm again repeating, we will give the 8 bit count to what? We will give the 8 bit count to the higher register, TH. For timer 0 it is TH0, for timer 1 it is TH1. Fine. So we will give the value to this TH registers. And then what will happen, it will keep on counting. For example, I have given the value, let's say I have given the count 02. Fine, so it will keep on counting 02 03 04, then tell 0a, like this till last value, which is FF is achieved. What will happen after FF? I have already told you, once the timer largest value of the register is achieved, then after this what will happen, a timer flag register TF, it would be set, it would become 1. Initially it is always 0 and it becomes 1. Now by using the programming, the user can check whether the count has been completed. Once your programmer is once through the programming, it is checked that the timer flag has been set. The timer flag has been set, that means the complete counting has been done. Now to continue the counting, you have the option. You have the option that you clear the timer flag and then you jump back again to the counting. You load again the TH0 and TL0 register. This is what we have done in our last lecture. You again load them and then continue the counting. But in this mode, mode 2, what will happen? You fed the value 8-bit count. This is limited to 8-bit count only. You fed the 8-bit to TH0 register and then a copy, please listen carefully, a copy of that 8-bit would be made into the TL0 by the 8051 itself. The programmer will not do this thing. I am again repeating, the 8-bit value, the 8-bit count will be loaded into TH0 register. Then that 8-bit count will be, a copy of that 8-bit will be made into TL0 register. And then this TL0 register will be incremented. How it will be incremented? For example, if you have written 02 in the TH0, so 02 value will remain here and a copy would be made into TL0 register. Fine. And now the TL0 would be incremented by the timer. It will become 03, then 04 till FF is achieved. Once the FF is achieved, the counting will again start from 00. Fine, because after FF it would be 00. But in the mode 2, what will happen? In the mode 2, once FF is achieved, again the timer flag would be set, it will become 1. Fine, once it is set, then automatically the value of the TH0 register, which is 02, will be again loaded into the TL0. Fine, so user need not to load the value into the register again. I'm again repeating what we were doing in the mode 1. We are once the counting is complete, we are again loading the value into the register so that it could restart the counting. Fine, but in mode 2, what we will do? In the mode 2, it is not required, because in the mode 2, we are giving the 8-bit count to the higher 8-bit register, which is TH. Fine, and then a copy of that value is maintained into the TL, is given to the TL register, the lower 8-bit register. This lower 8-bit register will maintain the counting, and a copy of the count from where it has to be started, it will remain in the TH0 register. Every time the TL register count to the final value, which is FF, after this what will happen, whatever was the original count, original value from where the count would be started, that would be again reloaded into the TL0 register, and now it will again start the counting from the value which was initially saved into TH0. This is what mode 2 is. Fine, and therefore mode 2 is also known as 8-bit reloaded mode. 8-bit because the 8-bit value is loaded into TH, and reloaded because each time the count is completed, it is again reloaded with the same value which we have initially given. Fine, so we were doing the same thing in the mode 1, but in the mode 1 we have to do it manually. Fine, let us go to the same example which we have done in our last video lecture, so that it would be very clear to you. We have done which example? Just a second. We have done this example, right? This example. So what we are doing here, see, we were feeding the value. This is what, this is the count from where it has to be started. Fine. So we were feeding the value to the TL0 and TH0 register. Fine. Now what we have done after this, we have started the counting. How to start the counting? Set the register TR. Fine. We have started the counting and it keeps on checking whether the count is completed. When the count is completed, the timer flag is set. When the timer flag is set, that means the count is completed. Now it will clear the TR0 and then it will clear the TF flag, and then we will return. Return where? From where we this program has came. It will return to which line? It will return to this line. This line. And what this line says? That we should jump to here. Here means we will again load the values into the register. So you see the difference. In the mode 1, what we were doing, we have to load the values. If we wanted to restart the program, restart the counting, once the counting is done, we have to load the TL0 and TF0 register, TL0 and TH0 register again to restart the counting. But in case of mode 2, what we have to do? We need not to do this step. We need not to do this step. Fine. In the mode 2, once we set our timer in the mode 2, we need not to reload the count again to TL0 and TH0. Fine. This is the difference between mode 1 and mode 2. We will quickly jump to the example so that mode 2 would be clear to you people. Fine. So let's see, where's the example? Yes, this is the example. Yes, this one is the example. Yes, we have started from here. This is the picture which is showing that what has been done. We are using the counting. We are using the clock of the 8051. Then divide by 12 means the machine cycle. I've already explained this divide by 12 theory in my last video lectures. Please go through them. Whenever timer bit is set, then the timer will start counting, and where it will count? It will count in the TL register. It will not use the TH register. Fine. Whatever is the value in the TH register, that would be loaded into TL. I'm talking about the mode 2. Fine. So it will be loaded into the TL register and it will start counting. Once the TL register is completed, or the counting has been completed in the TL register, the value FF has been achieved, the timer flag will be set. Fine. Programmer will check whether the timer flag has been set. Timer flag has been set or not. Once the timer flag has been set, you make it as a 0, and then the value which is in the TH register initially will again be loaded into TL, and the counting will restart. Fine. So this is the way how it goes. So I'll explain all these things with the help of the example. Let us see. I have this program. Fine. What this program is doing? Again, the same thing which we have already seen in last video lectures. This program is using a pin which is P1.0. P1.0 is a pin which is of port 0. This is of port 1, 8051 has many ports, so port 1, we are using port 1. The 8 bits of port 1, it is using the pin number 0. So from the pin number 0, you are getting a square wave, something like this. Fine. So this program is generating that square wave. Fine. So what we have to do, we have to calculate the frequency of this square wave. And the important thing is that this square wave is generated using timer, and the timer is operated in mode 2. So this example will be used to understand the mode 2 also. Fine. So let us see how it is done. we wanted to get the output from pin number 0 of port 1. Fine. So what we need to do? We need to make the P1.0, make the output from P1.0. Fine. So this is P1.0. Now what value to be given, we'll see. First we will set the mode of the timer. So how to set the mode of the timer? We have to pass the value to the T mode register. We have seen already in the last video lecture. So what value need to be given? We are using the timer 1 here. We having the T mode register is divided into two different parts, the timer 0 and the timer 1. Fine. So it has been said that we have to use the timer 1, not the timer 0. So all these values would be 000. Fine. And now for timer 1, since we are using which mode? We are using the mode 2. So mode 2, the last two bits would be 10. For mode 0 it is 00, for mode 1 it is 01, for mode 2 it is 10. The last two bits, the first two bits stands for C by T. Since we are using it as a timer, so we will use at 0. And then the last bit, or the most significant bit, MSB. The MSB stands for out gate control. Gate control means whether we are controlling it by programming or we are controlling externally. Since we are controlling this through programming, so we'll keep it 0. So what is the value? 0010. 0010 means 0010 means in hexadecimal 20H, because this is 2 and this is 0, so that means 20H. So we have to move the value 20 to the T mode register. Let's see in the first line of the program. We have moved the value 20 to the T mode register. Then we will move our count. Fine. So we have moved. It's already been decided that what frequency to be generated using this pin. So we need not to understand that why this value has been moved. Fine. So what we have done in this program, the value 5, which is a decimal value, it's not a hexadecimal value. If it has been hexadecimal value, H would have been written here. Fine. So if H is not written, that means by default it's a decimal value. So 5 has been loaded into the register TH1. Please note, since we are using mode 2, so we need to pass the starting value of the count into TH register only, not the TL register. Fine. Only to the TH register, not the TL register, because whatever value you give to the TH, the same copy will be made into TL, because we are using mode 2. Fine. So what we are doing, we are moving the value to the TH register. Then we will start the TH register. How to start? We start the timer. How to start the timer? Just set the bit of that particular timer, set the TR bit. Fine. Since we are using the timer 1, so we set the bit of the timer 1, set TR1. So your timer will start counting. Now just keep checking. We will always use this line in this section. This line means jump if bit is set. Jump if bit is set means whether the timer flag has been set or not. Timer flag will become set when the counting is completed. So it will keep on checking whether whatever we have given to the TH, whatever you have given to the TH, for example, now you have given the TH as 05. So it will count like this: 05, 06, 07 till 0A. Then what will be the next value? 10, 11, 12 till FF has been achieved. Fine. Now, whether the TH will be incremented? No. What will happen? The value inside the TH, which is 05, will be copied. All this thing will be done automatically by 8051. The programmer need not to take care about this. The value of the TH will be made copied into TL. So now the TL will contain 05. Initially, TL and TH both were containing 00. We have given the value to the TH and said that we are using mode 2. Now, the value which is in the TH will be copied into the TL, and TL will be counted from 05 till FF. Fine. And then we are checking whether the FF has been the last value, which is FF, has been achieved in TL register or not. Fine. So how to check? This line, jump if bit is set. So we are checking the flag bit. Fine. So once if the bit is set, then it will move to the next line, other will it will remain to this line, and your counter will keep on counting. Fine. So once your values value has been achieved, whatever is the value on the P10 pin, zeroth pin of P1, it will be complemented. Initially it was 0, then it will become 1, or if it was 1, it will become 0. So this is how the square wave is generated. Fine. So it will be complemented, and then you have to clear the timer flag, because in the next count the timer flag will again again set. So you need to clear it, and then you have to jump back to which place. This is important. In the mode 1, you was jumping to the this place, because you have to again load the timer registers. Fine. But in mode 2, you need to jump only to this line. Why? Because you have already made it 0, the flag is become 0, and whatever the TL register, the it has reached to the maximum value FF. Fine. Whatever is the value in the TH, which was 05 initially, it has been copied to TL, and now it has been copied to TL, and now it has again started counting 05 06 07. Fine. So you need to again jump to this line, which will keep on checking whether now the counting which has been restarted has been completed or not. Fine. So the difference between mode 1 and mode 2 is this, that in mode 1 you have to jump from this line to again this line, because you again have to load the register. But in case of mode 2, you have to jump from this line to this line, because you need not to load it again and again. So this is known as auto reload mode. Fine. Now let us quickly jump to this task which we were using this example. Mode 2 is clear to everyone. Fine. Now when the mode 2 is clear, then we will jump to this program, that what we are doing in this program. Actually, in this program we are generating a square wave from P1.0. Fine. Now they want that what is the frequency of this square wave. First we need to understand that what is the total time which has been generated here. Once we know the time, then we can calculate the inverse of the time, that will be the frequency. Fine. So how to calculate the time? Because the clocks, the timing which is maintained here is of the original clock which was given to the 8051. And what is the time period of the original clock which was given to the 8051? If you remember, it is 1.085 microsecond. Please remember this. It is 1.085 microsecond, because we are giving it as a 11 megahertz of frequency. Please remember this value. We are giving 11 megahertz of frequency to 8051, and because of this 11 megahertz frequency, the time period of each machine cycle, please remember, the time period of each machine cycle is 1.085 microsecond. Fine. How to calculate this value? I've already shown you in my last video lectures. Please go through that. So the time period is 1.085 microsecond. What is this time period of each clock? Fine. Now how many counts it is counting? It is counting from 5 till the last value. What is the last value of a 8-bit register? 8-bit register counts something like this: 00, 01, 02 till FF. And what does FF mean? FF means 256 in decimal. Fine. So it will count till 256. Fine. So how is the counting going? The count is going something like this: 00, 01, 10, 11. Fine. And then 100. The counting is something going like this. And till how many count it will go? It will go till 256. Once it will go to till 256, it will, this is again complemented. Fine. So for starting from 05, because we have loaded it to 05, starting from 05 till the 256 count, it will remain, let us say it will remain to 0, what the value P10. Now after this, your timer again will be loaded. Fine. Your P10 pin will be complemented. If it was 0, it will become 1, and from 0 it will again count from 05 till 256. So it will again keep this one will remain up till 256, and then this will be again reloaded. So the value at the P1.0 pin or the output from the P1.0 pin would be something like this. From 05 till 256 count, it will remain 0. It will remain 1 from again start from 05 till 256 count, then it will again remain 0. So a kind of square wave will be generated. So what they are asking, that tell them the frequency of this square wave. Fine. So to know the frequency of this square wave, you need to know the time period of this square wave. Fine. And how to calculate the time period? See, we need to know this value. Fine. In terms of decimal, what is the total count? Total count would be 256. Please listen it carefully. 256 minus 05. 256 minus 05 is 251. So 251 is the total count. But each count is of how much time? Please listen it carefully. Each count is of how much time? Each count is of 1.085 microsecond. Why? Because the timer is using the same clock which is used by 8051 and 8051 microcontroller, and the time delay or the time period of each machine cycle of 8051 is how much? 1.805. So the count of this timer, each count of this timer would be of 1.085 microsecond. Fine. And how much count it is counting? It is counting from 05 to 256, that is 251. So it is counting 251 counts for, let us say, 1, and it is counting for 251 counts for 0. Now since each count is 1.085, then we can multiply it by 251, so that we will get this much amount of time. Fine. And then we will again multiply 1.085 with 251. This much. Then we'll get this much time. We can add both the time, this time and this time. So we will get the time period. It is looking complex, but it is far easy. See, once you know how to do this, it will be very easier for you. Let's see how it is done. See, we should know how much counting has been done. Counting has been done from 05 to 256. The total counting is 251 multiplied by 1.085. Why? Because each count is of length 1.085 microsecond. The total became 251 multiplied by 1.085, that is 273 microsecond. But this is for what? Either total 0 or either till 1. So this is how much we have calculated. We have calculated it as 272.33 microsecond. Now this will be again the same 272.33 microsecond. So we will simply multiply it by 2. So we multiplied 272.33 by 2. So we got the time period of this. Now we have calculated this. This is how much? 544 microsecond. Now how to calculate the frequency of this wave? Just inverse the time period. So on inversing the time period, we got the frequency as 1.8 kilohertz. Fine. So the explanation seems to be very, very bigger, but the solution is very easy. So once you study this program again or listen to my lecture again, then this would be very clear to you that how this program has been done. So all the students are advised to go through such programs. There are more examples below here. You can go through these examples. I am not going deep into the each example because all examples are similar. So you go through these examples. Such questions will be asked in your mid-semester exams as well as in your semester exams. Fine. So please go through these questions. Now we will move to the next section, that is, see, what we have done from starting, we have studied the timers, we have studied the TMOD resistor. Come back to the TMOD resistor. In the TMOD resistor, the 8 bits are divided into two parts, 4 bit and 4 bit. Fine. The 4 bit lower belongs to the timer 0 and the higher 4 bits belongs to the timer 1. What were the bits? It was M0, M1. This M0, M1 defines the mode. Mode was mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. We need not to study mode 0 in this syllabus, neither mode 2, 3. We have to study mode 1 and mode 2, which we have already studied. Now the third bit was C by T. That defines whether you want to use a timer as a counter or a timer itself. And the fourth bit will define whether you want to control it externally or internally through programming. So now in this section we will study this bit. If we make it 1 or keep it 0, what will happen? Till now we are keeping this bit as 0. So this is used as timer instead of counter. But what if we make this C by T bit as 1? If we make this C by T bit as 1, then it will be used as counter. Please remember, this will be used as a counter. What will be the difference? The only difference is that, please listen it, the only difference is that everything will remain same. The modes, the mode 0, mode 1, mode 2, the reloading of from the TH0 register to the TL0 register in the mode 2, everything will remain same. The only thing that will change is, you can see through this graph, yeah, the only thing which will change is when you select C by T as 1, the only thing that will change is the clock which you are feeding to it. Please look at the previous figures. Let's go to the previous figures. One of the figure, if there is one, yes. What is done here? The clock which we are giving to the timer, the clock, please listen it carefully, the clock which we are giving to the timer is which clock? Is the clock which is used by the 8051 microcontroller itself. Fine. So the 8051 microcontroller is using a clock, the same clock is used by the timer. Fine. Now if we make this C by T pin, see, the C by T pin is 0 here. Fine. What if we make this pin as 1? Then instead of using the original clock of the microcontroller, it will use a externally provided clock. Fine. It will use a externally provided clock. See it here. When you are making the C by T pin 1, then you have to give the input or the clock through pin 3.4 or 3.5. What are these 3.4 and 3.5 pins? See, it's given here, 3.4 and 3.5 pins. The 3.4 and 3.5 pins are this. The 3.4 and 3.5 pin. The 3.4 and 3.5, you understand? That is port 3, the 4th and 5th pins of port 3. Fine. What are the 4th and 5th pins of port 3? If you go to the pin diagram, it is nothing but the pin named as T0 and T1. Did you remember the port 3 can be used as an input output, can be used for the input output data, and can also be used for this function T0 and T1. Fine. Now I'll again explain it to you. What will happen through this figure? What will happen if you are using the timer 0? If you are using the timer 0, the pin 3.4 is for timer 0 and 3.4 is the timer 1. If you are using the timer 0 and using any mode, either mode 0, mode 1 or any mode, let us say mode 2 you are using, mode 2 is given, then a count will be loaded here, that will be counted. Fine. A count will be loaded to TH, a copy will be loaded into TL, that will be counted. Once the count completes, the overflow flag will be set. This is the thing which we have already studied. Fine. Now everything is same. The only thing which changed is the clock which we are giving to this timer. This time the clock will be given to from the pin TR0 externally, since you have made the bit C by T as 1. because you have made the bit C by T as 1, now you have to give the clock from the outer. From which pin we have to give? If you are using timer 0, then you have to give the external clock through T0, and if you have make the using the timer 1, then you have to give the value from T1. That's it. It's very easy. Fine. So how is the difference between, then what is the difference between counter and a timer? How it is used as a counter? What I am saying that if you make C by T pin bit as 1, then it will be used as a counter. But here what we are doing, we are just giving the external clock. What is the difference between counter and timer then? Actually, what it is doing, you are giving an external pulse from here. Fine. So you keep on giving the external pulse. You keep on giving the external pulse until the count which is loaded here is completed. Fine. At that time, when the count is completed, your timer flag is set. Fine. Once your timer flag is set, through the programming you can know whether your timer flag is set or not. Once your timer flag is set, that means this much count has been completed. This much count has been completed. How much count? The count, the pulse which you are giving from outside. That's why this is known as counter mode. And previously which we were studying was known as timer mode. It's very easy. Fine. So this is the use of that pin. Now there's one more register which is known as TCON register. So please don't confuse. We just have four registers in this section which we have studied in the timer section. One was T0 register. T0 register which was holding the 16 bit counting value. One was T1 register, again holding the 16 bit count value. One T mode register which is used for setting the mode of the counter, and one TCON register. Just one more register. Just only four register you have to study. So TCON register. What this TCON register contains? This TCON register contains the status of the timers. Fine. Did you remember we were using the bits TR0 and TR1 to start and stop the timer? If you set the TR0 bit, your timer 0 will start. If you clear the TR0 bit, your timer 0 will stop. Fine. Similarly, once your count has been completed, you have two bits, TF0 and TF1. What are those? This will show whether the timer count has been completed. So TF0 will become 1 when your timer 0 count is completed. Similar for TF1. So where these bits are inside the timer? It's here. It's inside the TCON register. The first 4 bits are dedicated to the status of timers. It contains 4 bits. One are the starting and stopping bits of timers. These two bits belongs to timer 0. These two bits belong to timer 1. This is TR0, TF0 and TR1, TF1. So these 4 bits are stored here in the TCON register. The rest 4 bits belong to the interrupt. This is used for interrupting. So once we study the interrupt, then we'll go to this section. But you remember the names, because TCON register could be asked to you, then you have to understand only these 4 bits, why these 4 bits are used, and you have to remember what is the name of these 4 bits. That's it. You need not to understand its functionality. Once we study the interrupts of 8051, we'll understand the functionality of each bit. Fine. So again I am repeating why TCON register is used. The TCON register is used to maintain the status of the 8051 timer. Fine. Now the last bit in the T mode register, again we'll go to the T mode register. Last 4 bits or the first 4 bits of T mode register, it was M0 M1. This will decide the mode. So we have studied the modes. This C by T, this will decide whether we are using the counter or timer. We have studied this. The last bit is gate. So this gate bit, when this is 0, it means you are internally controlling the counting. Fine. You are giving the value to TH0 and TL0 internally through programming. So you are making the counting or the timing internally. But what if you make the gate value as 1? If you make this gate value as 1, then you have to control the counting externally. Fine. So let's see how it is done. When you make the bit, when you make the bit gate equal to 1 inside the TMOD register, then you have to use the second bit and the third bit. You have to use the second bit and the third bit of port 3 again. See, port 3, how many bits we have used? Let's see, port 3, 0, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. So, 3rd and 4th bit was for timer 0 and timer 1, which where we were giving the external clock. Fine. Now, 2nd and 3rd, 1st, 2nd and 3rd. So, 2nd and 3rd is known as INT0 and INT1. Exclusively, this is used for interrupt, but in timer section, we will use this for external timing. Fine. So, pin number 2 and pin number 3 of port 2, port 3 will be used for external counting, like a counter. If similar to a counter which you are having in your smartphones. How do you count in smartphones? You have a tool in a smartphone that whenever you click by using your finger, it keeps on counting until you stops it. So you use your finger to start and stop. Similarly, you will use the port pin number 2 and pin number 3 of 8051. Of port 3 of 8051 to start and stop the counting. Fine. Previously, what we are doing, we were using the pins, using the bits TR0. We are setting it or clearing it. By setting and clearing, we can start and stop the timer. But if we wanted to externally handle the timer, then we have to make the bit gate as 1 and provide the value. Provide the starting and stopping value from the ports 2 and 3, from the bits 2 and 3 of port 3. Fine. So how it is done? Let's see. See, if you are making the if you have made the gate equal to 1, and if you are using counter or timer equal to 0, that means you are using internal clock. Fine. Or if you are using counter or timer equal to 1, then your pin number 4 and pin number 5 of port 3 will be used to provide the clock. Fine. Now, if you have made gate equal to 1, if you have made gate equal to 1, then pin number 2 or pin number 3 will be used to provide the input as a signal. So once you give the signal, your counting will start. Your counting will keep on starting. And once you remove the signal, your counting will stop there and then. This is the only difference when you provide the external gate or not providing the external gate. That's why this bit is known as gate bit. That gate bit means you can start and stop the timer through externally. That's it. So this is the difference between external control and the input program control. The examples which are used here is of C language. So we will not go through these examples because it is not covered in your syllabus. And this is everything about what I have to told you about the timer. So your syllabus would be covered through this much only, what I have made you in these two lectures. And you can go through these examples which I have already told you. Some of the examples which we have studied, you can go through this example also. Fine. This was about the mode 2. This example was about the mode 2. Fine. So you, and mode 2, apart from that, this example was about the using as a counter. Fine. Using as a counter. So example is same because we need not to take care of what value we are giving as a start, because we are in the mode 2, when we are making the C/T bit as 1, we are only using the external clock. So as a programmer, you need not to take care of this. So your program will remain same. That's why I have not explained this program, but you can go through this program. please, I advise all the students to go through all these programs, because all these programs will be helpful in your semester exams also. So please go through all these exams and this much theory, what I have told you, that means that will be sufficient for your semester exams. Fine. So this section timer has been completed, and we'll look to the new section of your unit 3. That would be the interrupt in our new video lecture. Fine. That's it as of now. Thank you, everyone.